So I met with my command staff. We came up with a game plan.
Must have been glad to see you.
Sir?
Well, you can only delegate so much before they forget who their actual boss is. Or so I'm told.
I've never been one for sitting behind a desk, sir. I like to be out in the community.
The one you serve in the Bronx or the one you're moving to in Westchester?
I didn't want to say anything until the final offer came through.
Newcastle Chief of Police, nice ring to it.
Yes, sir. The schools are great. My wife, Emily, she's excited to raise the kids outside the city.
I understand. I do. Lieutenant General Lloyd Frendenhall, you ever heard of him?
No, sir. Can't say as I have.
Well, he was famous for leading his men to the worst U.S. defeat in World War II, the Battle of Kasserine Pass in North Africa.
Okay.
Turns out Eisenhower paid a secret visit to Frendenhall's HQ. Found an utterly confused environment, lacking in preparation, dedication, motivation.
You're saying that's the 5-1.
He also learned that Frendenhall had been spending a lot of his free time designing a bulletproof Cadillac, just like the one Ike had been issued. Well, that may have been the final straw. At any rate, Frendenhall was out on his ass.
Look, Commissioner, this last year, we've all been through. And my precinct's like a war zone.
Well, I'd watch that. The punishment for desertion during wartime is death.
I meant metaphorically. Obviously.
Yeah. Well, you're dead on. This last year has been like life during wartime. For this department, for this city we serve, and you commanded a fort in the Bronx and abandoned your duties there.
With all due respect, Commissioner, I don't have to take this.
You might want to double check that Chappaqua offer.
They called you?
I called them.
You're going to destroy my career, sir?
You did that yourself. Dismissed.